Well, wipe up this, make sure the ABS sensor's cleaned off here. Kind of important to me. There it is. Torque this guy down. There we go. Now, we'll put in my zip fitting. Take our grease gun. Caliper bracket, guide pins, and I'll be back. The frozen caliper guide bolt, or guides, are cleaned up. They're not rusty. They move real well. Should allow the caliper to return perfectly awesome. Light. Now, let me put the rotor disc back on. Who? Come on.
There we go. Walk this side in, walk this side. Brackets all cleaned up. Looks good. Now, did a hair bit of an I see. Just a hair bit. Where the pads ride. It's all. Clean this up. Now, if there were aluminum hardware here, stainless hardware, I would not put this on the stainless hardware. There's no stainless hardware here. So, I do this to keep it from rusting. Rust jacks and the pads and whatnot over time. Now let's find the pads and stick them back in. This is the rear pad. Well, what pad? Well, I'll go up here above our upper control arm. Take our caliper back out. And we will slide it out. Looks like a good. We're gonna start both of these by hand. Looks like to start the bottom one first. And kind of pivot off of it. Come on. Tighten these up. Set up like so. Whoops, there you go, dropping it.
Didn't hurt it. Gonna line it up. And I won't bonk it with a regular hammer. I don't want to hurt it. There we go. That's how I like to do that. I double check my work, of course, and I call it good. Now, we've done the front end on a 96, well, this is a 97. 95 to 97 a piece of that. It's starting to rain on me. So, yeah, we better go. See all the raindrops? She's starting to rain. We got a storm brewing, so I'm cutting it close. So I'm going to turn you off, and I'm going to get you this stuff picked up, and I'm going to hustle. And thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day.